Donald.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. What we see today, yet again, is the horrendous impact of austerity cuts on the state of prisons. The fact is that prison staffing levels are down by almost one-third since 2010, and that contrasts, by the way, to a 14% increase in Scotland over the same period. So we join calls for significant resources for prison officers, new prison officers, for staff retention, for equipment and training in the forthcoming budget. But specifically on the issue of overcrowding, the Prisons Minister has spoken about keeping a close watch on how the presumption against short sentences is working in Scotland. But surely he must see that placing people for a few months in institutions like Bedford or Birmingham or wherever else is utterly counterproductive. He has described exactly the complex needs which prisons just cannot address, particularly in a short period of time. So instead of watching, surely the time is now for acting on short sentences.
Yeah. Minister.
So the Honourable Member, Mr. Speaker, has raised a very interesting question. Connected to the question of crowding in prisons is the question of how many people are sentenced. Clearly the two are related. And the question the Honourable Member has raised is one that has been led by the Scottish Government, which is, what is the point of sending someone to prison with a three-month sentence? What are you achieving? In effect, that means that somebody is in prison for less than 6 weeks. Is that really a length of time that allows you to actually take any kind of punishment? Is it enough time to actually deter anybody? And above all, is it enough time to actually rehabilitate someone? Is it enough time to really turn their lives around and put them back so they don't reoffend? The evidence suggests that those very short sentences, in fact, are likely to lead to more reoffending than a community sentence. And this is something we need to look at very carefully.